Hi everybody, I'm Chelsea. In this first video, Daniel and I are going to be walking you through how to navigate to the Netlogo website that we will be using to start building agent-based models. We will also discuss how to start a new model that will allow you to build your own artificial world. We will then teach you how to save the new model onto your computer.
Hey there everyone, Daniel here. So the first thing that we're going to do is to go ahead and navigate to Netlogo Web. So open a browser window and navigate to netlogoweb.org. And whenever you come to the web page, it'll pull up a random Netlogo model for you. And so this will be just a random model from their library. And feel free to interact with this and play around with it. Get used to the interface elements. If you need to pause the video here, that's fine. But I'm going to go ahead and, for the purposes of the video, go into creating a new model. So go ahead and when you're ready, click on the new file up here at the top right. So what that gives us is a blank model. So this model is essentially a blank slate for us to start building our own world. So in the Netlogo interface, you'll notice a few things that are very important. So right here is a mode switch. Right now it starts on interactive mode. Interactive means that you can interact with the model. You can press buttons, you can change sliders, you can interact with the model. We're going to go ahead and change that to authoring mode, and that means that we can start building our own user interface elements for the model. Another couple of things that are important for the interface is this model speed slider. If you lower the model speed, you can kind of see how the interactions are playing out in real time. Whereas if you speed it up, you can run a bunch of simulations and get through the simulations very fast. Right here, this big black box is the visualization window. That's where you'll see your world, you'll see the agents, and you'll see the environment, and you'll see those interactions. And then this green area on the left is where you can actually start that authoring process. Since we're in authoring mode, it turns green, and that lets us know we can actually start building buttons. So let's go ahead and build one of those right now. So if you right click in the green area, you can you have all of these options that pop up. The one we want right now is to create a button. And this is going to essentially be our first button that's going to set up our model. So we're going to actually call this setup. We're going to make the display name the same thing. There may be situations where you want to put a command into a button that is not going to match the display name. Right now it's okay for them to match. So I'm going to call them both setup and click OK. Now the setup button is here and I can move it around and resize it and just make it look good on my Netlogo interface. So now that button is ready to use, but there's nothing to attach it to. So the setup command has not been built yet. That's the next thing we're going to do. But to signify that setup button has turned red. So when it's red, it means that there is no code for that button to access. When it turns black, that means it's ready to go. So let's go ahead and get into that part of it. Go ahead and switch your mode back here into interactive. It means you can press that button, but if you press it right now, it'll give you an error, which is okay. The other parts of this user interface that are important are the actual ways to input code. So first of all, there's the command center. This lets you input code directly. So you can actually type code in and it will happen on screen. We're not going to do too much of that during this workshop, but there are, if you start building more complex models, there are really good reasons that you might want to interact directly with the model through the observer. The other tab down here is the Netlogo code tab, and that's where we're actually going to get started and actually build our code that button will reference.
Okay, so now we will be talking about the basic code you need in the setup procedure. The setup procedure is what initiates your model and which you use every time before you run your model. In other words, it sets up your artificial world so that the agents in it can interact and do what you program them to do. The setup procedure, like all procedures, begins with first writing the word to, followed by the command. So in this case, we write to setup. Every procedure ends with end. So it is best practice to write this immediately before you add any other commands to the procedure. So you'll just push enter and add end on the line below. Setup procedures generally always also include the commands clear all, which erases all of the data produced during any prior model runs so that you start with a fresh, clean slate. We also write reset ticks. Daniel will talk a bit more about what ticks are when he discusses the Go procedure. Now we are going to do something a bit more fun. We're going to create the first turtles, or agents, in our model. Netlogo uses the term turtle to describe any agents that you have in the model. agents, or turtles can be a variety of shapes, sizes, and colors. To create turtles, we simply type create turtles. Create turtles needs to be followed by a number of how many turtles you want in your model. Right now, we can just write 100, but we'll adjust this later on. Now, if we want to change the shape or color of the turtles, we will need to add some more commands in brackets following the create turtles command. Brackets are a common tool you will use in coding, which demonstrate that the code you are typing belongs to the command that precedes it. So we will add a bracket on the line after the code, create turtles, and then on the next line, we can type set shape. You can make your turtles a variety of shapes that are already included in the Netlogo code. But in this case, we'll make our turtles the shape of people. So in parentheses, we will type person after the set shape command. To change the color, we do something similar. First, we type set color. Again, there are many colors pre-programmed into Netlogo, but in this case, let's just write blue. Now, we are going to change the size of our turtles. On the next line, write set size 1.5. This changes our turtles to the shape of people who are the color blue with a slightly bigger size than the default turtle size.
Now that Chelsea's walked you through how to create the setup code, now we're actually going to build the go code, which means we're going to make the agents actually start moving around and doing something. So to build the go block, it's almost exactly like building the setup block. We still need to say to go and then hit return a couple of times and then type end. So this is going to be another block of code, another procedure. And so then when we hit the go button on the interface, then this particular code block will be called. So the first thing that we need to put into the go block is tick. And ticks are going to be the way that we keep time in the Netlogo code. So a tick can represent different kinds of time scales. So it can represent a minute or a day or a second or a week or a year. But either way, it's going to be tracked in ticks. So every time the go code runs, the model ticks up once. The point of the go code is to start making the model do something. So in this case, we're going to start very basic and we want to just make the turtles that we created using the setup code, we want to make them start moving. So we're going to actually start with a very basic turtle command. We're going to ask the turtles to perform a command. So the syntax for this is essentially typing out ask turtles, and then we want those brackets again. So those brackets are, as Chelsea said, that's the command we want to give to the preceding element. So in this case, we want to ask the turtles to do what's in the brackets. So in the brackets, we'll type out the command that we want the turtles to do. So in this case, we're going to start very basic. We're going to just ask them to move. So in this case, we want them to turn in a random direction. So the code for this is to RT or right turn random 360. That means they are going to turn somewhere in a circle. And then we want them to move forward. So then we'll type FD1. So right turn random 360 and then forward one. So make sure you type it exactly like it is on screen. So that when you press the go button, your agents will perform that task. So now that we have both blocks of code ready to go, we have the setup and the go procedures all worked out. Now we need to hit that compile button, and that's going to make sure that all the code is integrated into the actual model. After that, let's go up to the top and we can look at our Netlogo interface again. Now, if you'll remember from earlier, all we built was the setup button. So see if you can pause the video here and figure out how to create a go button for yourself. So just to refresh your memory, the way you create a button is to right-click on the green space, you will create button, and then you will type into that command go. And after that, all you need to do is hit OK, and the go button is ready to go. So you can resize it and make it look good. When you're ready though, we need to start to be able to interact with these buttons. So let's go ahead and switch that mode switch back to interactive mode. And now we can actually use the setup and go buttons. So you'll want to hit setup first, and then you see all of your turtles appear, and then hit go and see what happens. So hopefully you have something very similar to what I have here. You hit the setup button and it creates all the turtles. Then you hit the go button and it'll make them all turn and I'll move forward one. And so you can hit that go button multiple times and have it step forward. Every single time you hit it, they'll turn again and then go forward one.
Now we will save our models. At the top of the model page, you'll see in the right-hand corner a line that says export. Click on the box that says Netlogo next to export. A box will pop up that allows you to name the file you are about to download. Save your model with the .in logo after the name, and then click OK. Your web browser may ask you to make sure that you want to download the file. If so, allow it to download, and then your file will be in your downloads folder. You can save it in another appropriate location on your computer if you like. In summary, in this video, we learned how to access the Netlogo website, learned about navigating the user interface, and learned how to write the setup and go procedures. We also learned how to save our models to our computers so we can upload them and work on them again later. See you next time.